Good morning, children. Praise the Lord. We meet again today. Stay happy and healthy in this new day. Before we start our today's activities, let's listen to God's word this morning. Taken from the book Straight Ahead, written by Adley A. Estep, PhD. And this morning, we will learn from the title, My Sweetest Defeat. Before we proceed, shall we start with a prayer? Thank you, Lord, for the new day. Now we are ready to listen to your words. May your Holy Spirit be within us to lead us and bless us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Our memory verse for today is from Matthew chapter 5, verse 44. It says, But I tell you, love your enemies and pray for those who persecute you. Children, My Sweetest Defeat by Deborah Whitmer was the first prize winner of a guidepost writing contest. She wrote of her experience in a high school tennis tournament. We resumed playing, but in a few minutes, the same thing happened again. What should I do? She was deliberately miscalling my shots and picking up points that belonged to me. Should I accuse her of cheating and create an ugly scene? It would be her word against mine. Then I remembered the verse from the Bible. Pray for those who persecute you. I walked slowly to the net. Mary, I said softly and slowly, are you sure all those shots were really out? What's the matter, Debbie? She shot back. Do you think you are better than we are? Do you think you can't make mistakes? Quickly, I offered up a silent prayer from my heart. Oh, Father, help me to say the right thing now. Never mind me winning the match or the team's winning the tournament. Just let me show Mary that I care for her as a person and for what is right. No, Mary, I replied. I don't think I'm better than you are. I think God created us all equal, and He loves us all equally. And each of us developed our skill in tennis about equally too. But I tell you one thing, I'm a Christian, and as much as I would like to win, I don't want to if I have to cheat to do it. That wouldn't be honoring my Lord. I paused my breath. Mary was looking at me intently. I went on, You are a good player, Mary. You don't need to cheat to win. You can probably beat me without that. Then suddenly, her glaring, belligerent look faded and she broke into a big grin. Okay, Debbie, I admit I was really begging you so you would blow up and throw the match away. But I guess you saw right through that, didn't you? Sure, I didn't expect you to react like this and be nice to me. Children, we started to play again, but Mary didn't cheat anymore. She finally did beat me to seeds out three. But I won Mary, and that was more important to me. This is the end of our morning worship. Children, have you ever faced a cheating opponent? Or maybe you yourself have cheated while playing? Children, remember the advice from God's Word this morning, that you should not cheat in a game, even in any way. Remember that God gave you the ability to do all things. You just need to be diligent and practice a lot. Never be afraid and sad for a David. Keep the spirit to keep practicing. Ask Jesus to help you become a child who lacks honesty, even honest to admit your weakness. May the Lord Jesus bless and protect all of your children on this wonderful day. Amen.